update. My 28 male, wife 27 female, left me for 3 months and recently begged me to take her back. I said no, and no, everyone seems to be against me. I need some advice, strangers.
Before we get started, make sure to subscribe so you will never miss a video. So let's get started.
Update. My 28 male, wife 27 female, left me for 3 months and recently begged me to take her back. I said no, and no, everyone seems to be against me. I need some advice, strangers. Let me start by thanking all the people who responded. There was a lot of insight, a lot of advice, and a lot of support. And while there were certainly a fair share of people just looking for an argument, insulting me, making offensive comments, or trying to rope me into something called MGTOW, luckily, the vast majority of replies were great and stuff I could work with. Especially those who were in similar situations and those who were in said situation, but are the depressed party proved to give me some insight I sometimes didn't even consider. Also, I am sorry for not being able to respond to everyone. I really tried my best to respond, but there were so many comments, I honestly couldn't keep up anymore. But rest assured, I tried to read just about every single comment, so your advice likely did not go in vain, and I appreciate it. I ended up having a really good think about my entire situation, trying to wait out whether I would be able to give her another chance to begin with, as despite to post would give away was actually something I struggled with. I was a bit of an emotional mess after all, and honestly, I sort of lacked control over my emotions. As you might have noticed in some of my responses, sometimes I seemed nostalgic, forgiving, and nice. Other times, I seemed vengeful, resentful, and hateful. I will admit of the bat that this is all me, and like I told some people in messages, I was, and still, I'm not in the best of places emotionally. But I have been working on getting my own emotions under control the past few days, and I can say I am in better place than I was a week ago. But it will certainly take some more time for me to replicate from all of this. Now, after what people were likely looking to see, what ended up happening this week that made me decide to make an update post? Well, after all the thinking, I decided, regardless of what course I would be taking, as some people suggested, it would be my decision and my decision alone, not the decision of my parents, her parents, friends, or people on the internet, mine alone. A decision I would be the one living with at the end of the day. So I decided I would inevitably end up regretting it all if I did not at the very least talk to my wife and get some closure. So that is exactly what I did. 2 days ago, I decided to invite her to our home to talk about what us, our relationship, what I would be doing going forward, her depression and so forth. Basically, just to get it all on a table. Now, it would be impossible to narrate this entire conversation. And honestly, it was about some very personal stuff, so I would not want to even if I could. So I will instead try to break it down and give a summary of sorts. We ended up discussing our entire relationship. I must admit, it was very awkward and confronting as it was about a lot of stuff myself, in particular, had bottled up for so long. It was very hard for me not to start yelling. I told her I was exhausted. I told her everything we had been trying obviously had not been working. I told her I felt like a doormat. I told her she was not the person I married. I told her these 3 months had been liberating for me. I told her I was tired of it all. I told her that I felt like she wasn't doing anything to help herself. I told her she was not doing anything around the house. I told her a marriage is supposed to be a partnership, but I felt like I was basically married to myself and that I was the only partner in this relationship. Essentially, I unloaded the stuff I had been feeling for years by now. I told her I had a hard time not regretting the day I married her at this point. And while it obviously really, really hurt her to hear, she told me she knew. She knew I wasn't happy. She knew she had been anything but a partner. She knew she was horrible about it all. But she felt like whatever she tried, she always ended up fearing getting better. Getting demotivated to do anything, and that, when she left, she almost felt like she had burdened me enough. That, it wasn't for her, but for me. But that she went about it the wrong way and ended up blaming the therapist as an easy way out. Well, it was true the therapist had guided her in some way towards this decision. The decision she made was for the right reasons, but the explanation she provided was tailored to her, not me, which was disregarding the therapist's advice entirely. She said she felt guilty about it all and that guilt was just making her psychological state even worse. She said she hated seeing me going to work, coming home exhausted and having to clean everything up until I just passed out, essentially, which I might add in a massive step for her, as she never admitted this. But she started admitting a lot of stuff and apologizing for a lot of things in our relationship. She said her time away made her realize how much I mean to her and how much she took for granted and that she should have done better a long time ago. To which I told her, I felt like I had been enabling her essentially, while I had tried to keep her to her medication and all of that. At the end of the day, it was always me picking up after her, which probably made it easier for her to slip back into it all. Well, after hours upon hours of talking, we ended up hugging for what seemed like over an hour before going back to talking, and she basically said she understood if I would not take her back. She understood if I did not trust her to get better. She understood that I was tired, but she asked me to give her one more chance, and she would do anything for it. I have to admit, my mind immediately wanted me to go to the obvious option, which was not taking her back, not giving her a chance. But honestly, in this discussion, she was the person I was once in love with. She seemed to take ownership of things. She seemed different somehow. But I also knew the risk coming with taking her back, and honestly, I was not about to pull another Hail Mary. So I told her I would be willing to give it a shot, but it wouldn't be like before. Not at all. I told her she would have to prove she was going to put in the effort first, before we could even begin. Firstly, I told her she had to get a part-time job. I don't care what sort of job, whether it is waiting tables, at a clothing store, or at some company. It is irrelevant as long as she made sure to go every single time she was supposed to go, look presentable when going, and made sure she did her best at said job. Secondly, she knows I like going to gym. As such, she would be going with me at least 3 times a week, get in shape again, get some exercise, and most of all, be busy in a healthy way. Thirdly, she is going to help her parents around the house while she stays there. No more sitting in her room along with her thoughts, groceries, dishes, vacuuming, whatever. She was going to take an effort doing it every single day. Fourthly, some people suggested we were gonna go on a date once a week. No more escaping, not wanting to go outside, feeling self-conscious. No more excuses. Fifthly, we were going to do couples counseling. I know we tried before, but we will try again. Sixth, she's going to go to a new therapist, not lie about anything anymore, and do what a therapist tells her. Seventh, if the therapist suggests medication, she is going to take them every time she is supposed to take them, and I will keep them with me, and she will take them in front of me. No more forgetting, no more not taking them, no more complaining, and if there are issues with them, we will try the different ones, but regardless, she is going to stick to it. I told her, once we are doing all that, we can go to the next stage of repairing our relationship. But until she does them and keeps them up for a good few months, there is not a single chance I will continue our relationship. And yes, I know ultimatums are a taboo in a relationship advice, but I don't think I have much of a choice. To my surprise, she actually agreed, and to my even bigger surprise, despite it only having been 2 days, she was actually helping her mother and father around the house yesterday and has been looking for jobs. Her dad also said she seems a lot more cheerful. Now I know there is a long road left, and I know there is a good chance this won't work out, and that I should not cheer too early. But honestly, I am hoping I get my wife back, and I felt I owe it to myself to at least allow her this one last chance. Call me an idiot for giving her this chance, but well, perhaps I am an idiot. That was my update. I'm not sure whether I will make another. I had honestly not even planned on making this one. I want to thank the people who responded to my other post again for their insight and advice. And I hope all of you live happily ever after or something.